Hello friends, welcome back to the channel, The Student's Diary. So today we have something new to discuss about, and today our topic is The Talking Fan, the summary of the poem Talking Fan. You have fans at your home, right? Yes, you may be having fans, many fans at your home. Some may be having AC, some may be having fans, and so many other means to get air. So today we'll talk about a talking fan. What is the word talking means? Talking means one who speaks. So today we will speak about a particular fan that talks, that is speaking. And do you know what its chatters are? Its chatters are electrical. We are speaking and we have some sound, and it is formed through air. But the chatter, the speaking of the fan is electrical. Its chatters are electrical. So what is this talking fan? Have you ever in your life seen a fan that talks? Probably not, because normally fans do not talk. But why do we study about a fan that talks? That is a main thing we need to discuss today. So when we speak about a fan, or when we say that a fan talks, that time what happens? Normally we think that the fan is talking as we are talking. But exactly it is not like that. You may be having fans at your home that may be creaking, that may be making noise like keen keen. When you switch on the fan, you get some noise, and that is called, that time the fan talks. And it is demanding something. So when a child is hungry, what does it do? It cries and the mother comes and feeds it. So like that, we know that none of the non-living things can speak. Is the fan having life? No, absolutely not. The fan is not having life. But how does it talk? Yes, a non-living thing can also talk. How? In the form of making noise, because that is how they speak. So when the baby cries, mother knows that something is wrong. That means baby may be feeling hungry, therefore he or she or it cries. So mother goes and feeds it. So like that, when there is some technical problem in some device or in some machine, that time it starts creaking or it starts making some noise. And that is what, that noise, we say that something or some machine is asking for something, or we say that they talk. So who understands that? So in the poem, in 7th standard, the poem The Talking Fan, here the poet, he doesn't understand what does the fan speak. So he comes and hears it, the noise that the fan makes, and he thinks that the fan is talking, and he cannot understand what the fan talks. So being helpless, he leaves the room at once. But another times, another day, he comes and visits that the fan runs as still as water without making any noise. Why? Because the food that was needed to the fan, actually the fan was hungry. It was in need of food. What was its food? No sabji, no curry, no rice, no dal. But its main food was oil. So some mechanical came and oiled its body, oiled its small whirling body, or a small machine that rounds, and to the surprise, gone. All the mysteries were gone. So once again the poet's comment is that the fan runs as still as water. As water has no sound, water remains very still. So like that the fan runs very smoothly. So that noise that is created by a device, or that is created by this particular fan, it seems to the poet as the fan talks. That time he says that the mystery of the talking fan. What was the mystery? The mystery was that it was making noise, and the poet did not understand this, because the poet does not know the language of the fan. So that was a mystery to the poet. And he says after some times or after some days when he comes and visits again and he says that all the mysteries are disappeared. All the mysteries are vanished. Why? Because somebody has oiled it. So that was the mystery for the poet. Why does this fan make noise? And he thinks that actually the fan speaks. And thus he names the fan as talking fan. So I hope you understood the poem. And in the next video we will upload another poem or another chapter of your book. So after that, keep watching. Have a good day. Thank you.